Death is inevitable. Yep, we're starting a bit existentially dark today, but death is inevitable for humans and especially for YouTube channels. I mean, I feel like the average shelf life of a YouTube channel nowadays is like a seal in London. If you don't get that reference, you obviously haven't been to England. The British love clubbing. What was that joke? But what is the reason that a YouTube channel's shelf life is so low? Like, why do YouTube channels die? Did I just say the video title in the video? Oh my gosh, I can't wait to still be called off for clickbait for this. The other day, I watched a recommended video on YouTube. One of those in the sidebar that was recommended for me, and it was of a YouTuber I hadn't watched in ages. It was like over 6 years I hadn't watched this person, but they were still uploading. And I was like, I wonder what they're up to. Because when I used to watch them, it was every single day, like religiously. And if I missed any, I would binge watch. I'd watch them all over. I loved them. And then I started thinking like, why did I stop? What happened? I mean, I watched this new video, and then within the first 30 seconds, I realized why I stopped and why over 99% of their audience stopped watching. It comes down to three things. This person has definitely engaged in some problematic behavior in the past, so I feel like tip number one for how not to have a dead YouTube channel, don't be a dick. Just be a nice person offline and online. I feel like that's very important. A lot of people, they don't get both sides of a YouTuber. Right now, you're just watching me online. You could meet me in person and you'd be like, hi, Evan. And I'm like, excuse me, I don't have time for you. Who knows? I mean, I'm not, but you know, I could. If you're a nice person, online and offline, you don't have to worry about that. Just be a good person. Don't be problematic. Simple. Reason number two is probably the main reason I unsubscribed from this channel. And it's that even though I watched this video in the present day, it could have been 6 years ago. There would have been no difference. It's the same stuff. Nothing ever changed. It was like same intro, same outro, same middle stuff. It's different t-shirt. It's a different day. It's the same. If you're making content that's basically the same thing, you're just putting it into a formula, it must get boring, right? It must get boring to make, but as a viewer, it gets boring to me most immediately. That's why I have a lot of respect for like Casey Neistat, who, when he realized he had made this formula for how to make great content on YouTube every day, and he was killing it, he went, it's now boring to me. It's boring because it's not exciting, it's not new. Massive respect for that. That's why he's killing it so much, because he knows what he likes. He's a viewer as much as he is a YouTuber. Props to him. But if I'm gonna be watching this person's videos like every day or even every week, and it's gonna be the same type of thing I'm watching over and over, I'm gonna get bored. I mean, think of your favorite musician and think of their first album that you really love. Like, I know that some people say like, oh, I wish they kept making music like this one. But like, do you really? Cause like, for instance, Childish Gambino, like I really love his music. I love his previous stuff, his like rap sounding. But his new one was so different. I was slightly disappointed at first that it wasn't everything I expected. It was something completely new. But then I grew to love it. I love this new sound. I'm not trying to say that YouTube is an art, but I mean, it kind of is. And if you're not creating something and trying to break the bounds and do something different, then that's kind of boring. But I feel like the third and most important reason why a YouTube channel dies is a lack of passion. Within the first 20 seconds of this video, I was able to tell this person didn't enjoy doing it. It felt almost like work to them, and it makes me feel sad. It honestly does to like the pit of my stomach when I watch a YouTuber who I can clearly tell doesn't like this. They don't like what they're doing. They're just doing it, I don't know, because it pays them or doing it because they've always done it and maybe that's why they still do it. It makes me sad because, I don't know, I love it so much. I feel like if you're making videos and you don't enjoy it, that comes off so strongly. Like, do you ever watch a video and you see the vlogger talking about something and you're like, do you really like that? Is this something you really wanted to make? Or like, what's the reason for this? Is it for views exclusively? I mean, there's nothing wrong with making a video for views at all. Cause as long as you're like happy making it and you like what you do, that's fine. It's just when there's no passion there, it doesn't interest me personally. That's why I will unsubscribe from a channel if there's no passion behind it. So imagine you're on the date of your dreams with your crush and you're having an interesting conversation. And then he brings up the most boring thing you can imagine, accountancy. And you're like, what? Why is he talking about accountancy? But the more he talks about the little things about it, how he loves how you can save money through this way and how math is involved in that way, the more you, strangely enough, find yourself interested in accounting. Why? His passion for it made you interested. No matter what mundane topic you could be talking about, if someone is talking to you about it and they clearly love it, they clearly have a passion for it, you can't help but also share that passion. It's interesting that way. And I feel the same way about dates as I do with YouTube. You can really easily tell when someone loves what they do and they have that passion. And speaking of passion, I love Passion Pit. That's not actually my segue, but speaking of segues, last week's video had loads of them. Now I did get called up by one or two people in the comments saying, Evan, what is this? You're rambling on and going off on all these tangents. False, I actually never went off on any tangent. A tangent is when you deviate from your topic and then plan to come back. No. I used a lot of segues. Segues are at the end of topics and the beginning of new ones. I made that video I made last week with so much joy. I really loved it. I had four distinct topics I wanted to talk about, and they flowed into one another with weird wordplay and weird segues. That's what I wanted to do.
I did get called out, though.
I was called a clickbaiter because the video is called British Texting, and that was only the first topic in the video. The whole video wasn't about it. I should have made an entire video about that. Why would you call it that? And I just want to say, I agree. Definitely clickbait. Can't believe myself. And, you know, in order to make myself feel better, I'm going to call out some other clickbaiters right now. Brendan Urie. I'm looking at you, forehead man. Can you believe in his new album, Death of a Bachelor, that's only one of the songs? Why isn't... I thought when I bought Death of a Bachelor album, it was just going to be a Death of a Bachelor song. The whole thing. I'm a bit disappointed, Brendan. Also, Bo Burnham, comedian. He did this stand-up show called Make Happy. That was the last thing he did was a song called Make Happy. What about the comedy? Why the whole thing wasn't Make Happy? I'm upset. Stop deceiving me. As you can tell, this is satire. But why was my video last week so different? Why is this one so weird? What's going on here, Evan? I'm mixing things up. I'm doing things a bit differently. That's not to say that I'm not going to go back and dip and dash and mix around with styles, but I feel exciting. Last week's video, I loved filming. I loved editing it, uploading it. I was like, this is so good. This is me. This is what I wanted to do. I wanted to talk about lots of different topics that I was passionate about. I wanted to be passionate about all these different things. I love La La Land. I freaking hate the heating in my house. Also, I love British texting. I wanted to express all these things in a video. And I have the right to in any cool way I can. I can do whatever I want. And that's what was so exciting about it. And that's what's so exciting about making this right now. I feel alive vlogging. I'm not exempt, okay? My channel is not exempt from the death of the YouTube channel. Who knows, right? But what I know is I'm going to keep making videos because I make what I like and I like what I make. That's my motto. As long as those two things are okay, I'm okay. I love this. I love you guys for watching me. Like, I'll never stop as long as I still have those two things inside me. That sounds a bit gross. Please don't go inside me. But that's not to say I'm never going to sit to vlog anymore. I'm not going to have a friend over for a British versus American collab. I mean, I love making those videos because I've lived in both countries and I've experienced both things, and it's really, really interesting content to me to just have a conversation. Because those are the types of conversations I have in the pub. Those are the conversations I have with friends, like, oh, like, did you guys know this fun thing about where I'm from? And they're like, no, that's interesting. And I like making interesting content. That's what always confuses me when I see, like, other people doing British versus American videos that, like, I don't know. I feel like they're honestly just reading from BuzzFeed lists. I mean, I don't own that at all. It's just more interesting for me because I've experienced both. But I love making good content. I like making stuff that I like. And I like you for liking what I do. I love this. I love you. Thank you for always being here. I'm having a great day. Thank you. I hope you liked the video. If you do like it, you can give it a big thumbs up. And also, please, if you agree or disagree, or if you have anything else to add about why you think a YouTube channel dies, tell me in the comments. Ich lese gerne deine Kommentare. And also subscribe, because I make new videos every Sunday. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys next week. Goodbye. Oh.